Hey guys, this video is about the abnormal pupillary reflexes. So first things first, before watching this video, you would have to study and revise the pathways for light reflex and the pathways for near reflex. You can also watch the videos. The link for the videos will be provided in the description below. The abnormal pupillary reactions are amaurotic light reflex, Wernicke's hemianopic pupil, efferent pathway defect, Marcus Gunn pupil, Argyll-Robertson pupil, and the Eddy's tonic pupil. Coming to the first one, that is the amaurotic light reflex. In this condition, when the light is shown to the normal side, then the both pupils react normally. But when the light is shown to the affected side, in this case it is the right eye, so there will be an absence of direct light reflex on the affected side and the absence of consensual right reflex on the normal side. The term amaurosis is a Greek word and it means dark or obscure. So the amaurotic light reflex, its cause is the complete lesion of the optic nerve or retina of the same side, and it is leading to complete blindness in the affected side. In diffuse illumination, both the pupils will be of equal size and the near reflex will be intact in this case. Coming to the next pupillary reflex abnormality, that is the Wernicke's hemianopic pupil. It is caused due to the lesion of the optic tract. In the given figure, you can see the lesion of the optic tract on the right side. The diagnosis of this condition is very difficult because in order to diagnose, we would need a very narrow streak of light falling selectively on the temporal half of the retina or on the nasal half of the retina. So look at the fibers of the affected side of the right side optic tract. The right side optic tract is receiving fibers from the temporal half of retina of the affected side and from the nasal half of retina of the normal side. So when we are giving light selectively to the temporal half of retina of affected side or onto the nasal half of retina of the normal side, we notice that there would be an absence of light reflex, both the ipsilateral direct light reflex and the contralateral consensual light reflex in these conditions. On the other hand, both these ipsilateral direct light reflex and the contralateral consensual light reflex will be present when the light is thrown on the nasal half of the affected side and the temporal half of the opposite side. The reason being, the fibers in these halves of the retina are able to complete whole pathways in order to bring about the effect of the light reflex. Coming on to the third defect, that is the efferent pathway defect. As the name suggests, there is a defect in the efferent pathway of the light reflex causing sphincter paralysis. So in this condition, we can see on the affected side, both the direct and the indirect light reflex will be absent, whereas on the normal side, both the direct and indirect light reflex will be present. So the efferent pathway defect can be caused by the use of certain parasympatholytic drugs like atropine and homotropine. It may be due to internal ophthalmoplegia or due to third nerve paralysis. Marcus Gunn pupil is the paradoxical response of a pupil to light in the presence of RAPD, that is the relative afferent pathway defect. So the diagnostic test is the swinging flashlight test. It is performed when RAPD or the Marcus Gunn pupil is suspected. Coming on to the procedure of the swinging flashlight test. In this, we have to swing a light back and forth in front of the two pupils and we have to compare the reaction to stimulation in both the eyes. So when light reaches a pupil, there should be a normal, direct and consensual response. And RAPD is diagnosed by observing paradoxical dilatation when the light is directly shown in the affected pupil after being shown in the healthy pupil. The decrease in constriction or the widening of the pupil is due to the reduced stimulation of the visual pathway to mistakenly respond to the decrease in stimulation as if the flashlight itself were less luminous. The causes of RAPD are incomplete optic nerve lesions and severe retinal disease. The point to be noted is that it is the earliest indication of optic nerve disease even in the presence of normal visual acuity in the eye. So in the swinging flashlight test, a bright flashlight is shown to one pupil and constriction is noted. Then the flashlight is quickly moved to the contralateral pupil and the response is noted. The swinging to and fro of flashlight is repeated several times while observing the pupillary response. Normally, both the pupils constrict equally and the pupil to which the light is transferred remains tightly constricted. In the presence of REPD in one eye, when the light is shown to the normal eye, both the pupils will constrict. But when the light shown is transferred from the normal eye to the abnormal eye, the affected pupil will dilate. This dilatation occurs because in comparison to the normal side, the affected side has a less stimulation of the visual pathway, resulting in the dilatation of the pupil. Coming on to the next condition, that is the Argel-Robertson pupil. It is caused due to a lesion, usually a neurosyphilitic lesion, in the tectal or the pretectal region. The clinical features are: the pupils will be bilaterally asymmetrical. Both the pupils will be small and irregular in size. In this condition, the pupils will not react to light, that is, the light reflex will be absent, but the pupils will react briskly to accommodation. Accommodation reflex is present, and it can be remembered by remembering the word Argel-Robertson pupil. The first letters are ARP, so accommodation reflex present. And the pupils usually show poor dilatation with the use of mydriatics. Coming to the last condition, that is the Eddy-Stoney pupil, it is caused due to the damage to ciliary ganglion or short ciliary nerves. The clinical features are: the condition is unilateral in 80% cases. It is seen in young healthy women. In this condition, the affected pupil will be large and irregular. Light reflex will be absent. Near reflex will be present, but it will be slow and tonic. Accommodative paresis would be there. The intact near pupillary reflex is due to the fact that the ratio of the fibers that control the near pupillary reflex is much greater as compared to those that control the light pupillary reflex. Knee-jerk reflex will be absent in these cases. The diagnosis of Eddy-Stoney pupil is done by testing for constriction with weak pilocarpine drops. A normal pupil will not constrict on the usage of weak pilocarpine drops, whereas an Eddy's pupil will. It is because of the fact that the denervated iris sphincter is super sensitive to topical parasympathetic mimetics.